On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Hello, my dear listeners. May God bless all of you who believe in the name of Jesus Christ. And I would like right now to speak about something that's urgent, just to try to save those that are about to kill themselves. Let us read the verse so that we may meditate upon it. This is what the Word of God says. For oppression brings confusion to the wise man. What is capable of making confusion? A wise person. What kind of oppression is this that makes the wise man confused? This confusion is what we see nowadays. Depression. Depression is hurting men and women, young people, old, poor, rich. Every kind of human being are subjected to oppression, to depression, actually, more than ever. Even the wise, even doctors now. I just heard it, that the statistics of the doctors is three times more than the normal, than the usual among people. So then, I want you to read again. Read with me this scripture that I just spoke. Ecclesiastes 7, verse 7. It says, we're going to read it once again to refresh your memory. It says, for oppression, we can even put that depression, because I believe in that time they didn't have the word depression. It was oppression, but it says brings confusion to the wise man. So the doctor that was taking care of a patient now killed himself simply because of the problem that he was trying to solve in one's life. And the rate of suicidal among the doctors is three times more now than those who commit suicide themselves. So, if we discover the cause of depression, because the cause of depression is not because of a loss, because people may lose husband, lose wife, and enter in depression. But if one gets married, that depression would not leave. And of course it would not leave, because one places all their hope, all their life in the person that they love. And then now, once one loses their loved one, and one enters in depression. So this is a disease that is strictly spiritual. That's right. It is strictly spiritual because it works deep within. Because when a person does not have a living faith, an active living faith, in practice, based on God's Word, it is obvious that this is going to take place. There are even pastors nowadays that are killing themselves, even though they are preachers of God's Word. But they are preachers only within. Because a person who preaches the Word of God and kills themselves, they are so possessed by evil spirits as people who don't have the will of God in their lives. Because this pain, I imagine this pain is the pain of the soul. And the pain of the soul cannot be detected with no machine. I understand the spiritual part. I do not know the physical, but I understand that as a person suffers with the pain of the soul, so the evil spirits that were in one's life making a person to be depressed in a way that you would feel pain. So people who are killing themselves, they are killing themselves because of this pain within the soul. And they do not know that if this pain is cruel as they are alive, imagine now this pain in hell, when they go deep into hell because they killed themselves. I came across a report that nowadays girls, women, are now killing themselves because of depression, because boys. One can preach the Word of God, but does not know the action of the devil in their life. And that's why pastors nowadays, they are now killing themselves. Simply because they don't know the Bible. Because a pastor who kills himself or takes his life is like the person who gets a book, like a science book, and then they study that book, understand it, and they absorb all the information from it, and then now they try to teach others, or they try to treat people because of that book, based on that book. So they had the knowledge of the Bible, but did not have the knowledge of the spirit of the Bible, the experience with God's Word. They know the theory, but do not know the spirit. And this is how many people that they study the medical book, and now they want to practice medicine. No, they must study. They gotta go to the university. There are thousands of books out there. So how can a person preach the gospel without not knowing or have an experience with the author of the gospel, which is the Holy Spirit? So that's the reason why people are confused, because they preach one thing, and I'm sure people like that, they are depressed. And one thing that I'm certain is that they are not delivered, they are not free, and they cannot live what they preach because they don't have the Spirit of God.
Shine my I had a lot of hate inside of me towards my mom. So I felt rejected. I felt like she didn't love me. I just always felt like if I was alone. I had a little brother at that time, which I always felt like if I was his mom, I was always taking care of him. Just a lot of situations in the house that I don't feel that I shouldn't have had to been placed in. I was very rebellious. I started drinking at a very young age. Just trying to fill that emptiness. When I left my house at 16, I had met my kid's father. We ended up living together. He was a gang member, and it was a different kind of suffering. He was unfaithful to me. He was involved in selling drugs. He was murdered, and he died in my arms. That was the beginning of another suffering. Because of all of that, we ended up being homeless. So me and the kids ended up living in the car. I didn't want to live. I was thinking about committing suicide because I didn't know how to be a mother and a father. You know, my son caught me in the bathroom with the pills in my hand. That was, I think, the hardest, you know. And that is where I said, this is it. I felt the difference when I left that first Friday. I started seeing things falling into place. You know, of course things come and go, problems, but it's, you handle them in a different way. Where there was hopelessness before, there was hope. They teach you how to use your faith. They teach you how to put it into practice, how to see results, you know, and get those fruits, see those fruits from your faith. An intelligent faith. All the curses are turned into blessings. He heard the preacher say, a single dime can feed a hungry boy or girl with nothing to eat. So he pulled a dollar from the pocket of his jeans, and he asked his mama, how many will this feed? She just smiled when she told him ten, he reached back in again. What if I give all I have? What will that gift do? My child, a gift like that could change the world. It could feed a multitude. Close his eyes or turn away. I can see him standing tall. He saw the need and I can hear him say, what if I give all? Three birthday dollars could have bought a special toy. He reminds me of another little boy who gave to Jesus a gift of fish and bread. I wonder if he said, what if I give all I have? What will that gift do? My child, a gift change the world, could feed a multitude. He didn't close his eyes or turn away. I can see him standing tall. He saw the need and I can hear him say, what if I give all? Long ago, a father and a son saw the children lost in sin. Can you see the tears in father's eyes as Jesus says to him, what if I give all that I have? What will that gift do? My life was completely destroyed before. My mother used to have a headache dealing with me because I would do bad in school. I would always get in trouble. The teachers, the principal would always call my mother, and I was just doing really bad. My life was this way because I never truly had happiness. And my dad wasn't really around much. So it was just my mother, she would just work to try to provide, but as far as spending quality time, we didn't have much of that. I was a very angry person, and I used to take it out on anybody I saw. I used to fight random people in the street. I just wanted to feel numb, so I used to smoke a lot as well. I would smoke to numb the pain. I would smoke to just get away from these feelings that I had of being alone. I would be with people from my neighborhood, and I lived in the heart of the ghetto. So it was the people who were there who sold drugs. I sold drugs as well. Violent, the gang members with the guns, everything. This is the type of life that I came to have. My mother didn't raise me this way, but that's what I got involved with. I had to smoke every day. I couldn't go a day without smoking. Even before school, I would go to school high. I had a boyfriend, and I found out he had given me a sexually transmitted disease. And that's when I hit rock bottom. That's when I felt like everything was just going out of control. So I had went to a clinic, and I went there to get a cure for the STD, and I was just there in the clinic room wondering what my life had become. I had an older brother who came to the church, and he would drag me to come along with him. I looked back and I couldn't tell who I had became. So this is when I realized that I needed to change. I didn't know how, but I wanted to change. I wanted to do better. I wanted to get back on the right track. When I stopped suffering, it felt like nothing I ever felt before. I felt like the burden was gone completely. And I felt way better. After time, I stopped smoking. I no longer had the craving to smoke. I no longer had the desire. That was gone. Talking to different guys, this was the next thing that changed, because I felt like now there was love. Now I knew God, and now I knew the love of God. Now I'm a completely different person. The wrong things, the problems that I was going through, they're gone. With the addictions, with the being violent, I no longer hang out with these wrong friends. And if I had to tell anybody advice, anybody who's going through my situation or something similar, what I would tell them is look to God. Despite what you heard about churches, despite what you heard about God, if anybody told you God's not real, I'm telling you God is real. And look to Him. Look to Him because He can help you. He could change you. He could get you out of any problem, out of anything you're going through.
I have wrestled in the darkness of this lonely pilgrim land, raising strong and mighty fortresses I alone command. But these castles I've constructed by the strength of my own hand are just temporary kingdoms on foundations made of sand. In the middle of the battle, I believe I finally found. I never know the thrill of victory till I'm willing to lay down all my weapons of defense and earthly strategies of war. So I'm laying down my arms and running helplessly to yours. treasure I obtained. If I measure my successes on a scale of earthly gain, if the focus of my vision is the status I attain, my accomplishments are worthless and my efforts are in vain. So I lay aside these trophies to pursue a higher crown. And should we choose somehow to use the life I willingly lay down, I surrender all the triumph, for it's only by your grace I relinquish all.
Life was a mess. Drug addiction and alcoholism. I had so many physical problems, and of course the depression just got worse. Really destroyed. I felt so desperate, so helpless. My name is Shansay, and this is my story. I had relationship problems. I had pretty much everything you can imagine. I had depression, suicidal thoughts. I also had a relationship that lasted 10 years, and I thought I was going to get married. And then I got a call one day from my boyfriend stating that, oh, I'm not coming home. So, of course, that made the depression even worse. It's just when you think it couldn't get any worse, it gets worse. I had a migraine headache, and this one was so, so bad. I mean, it was pounding. So when I met my husband, it got worse. He wasn't my husband yet. He was a boyfriend. Then I said, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? In the end, I ended up doing witchcraft. What happened then was it got so bad that I became so suicidal that one night I almost, took my life. I wanted to take a bunch of pills because at that point I was taking so much medication. And that was the night I was gonna commit suicide. You know, it was a flyer. It was more than that. It was like a pamphlet, and it had all these testimonies. But the cool thing was that I was looking at it and I'm like, wow, this is heavy duty. So I made up my mind, I said, I'm gonna do this thing. I'm gonna go, one last thing I'm gonna try. Gosh, I felt so good the day that I was stopped suffering from all of this. It was like a whole new life, a whole new chapter for me. My husband overcame that addiction. We got married a year later, and we're still married. We're going to be married 13 years next month. My advice is, anything that you want out of life, you have to work for it. It's not an easy fix. Me, change, completely leave the past behind, all those illnesses, all the sicknesses, all the hurts, the frustration, the disappointments, all that's gone. God knows what's going on, and he knew that once I came that I would give my 100%, I would give my all.
Take me past the outer court into the holy place, past the brazen altar. Lord, I long to see your face. Pass me by the crowds of people and the priests who sing their praise. Lord, I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, and it's only found one place. Take me into the holy of holies, and take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. Take the call, cleanse my lips, here I am. Bring me in the inner court and pass the golden light and through the incense altar. Lord, I long to see your light. Let me touch the color curtain and clothe in linen white, and part the veil that's hanging, oh, that keeps me from inside. Take me into the holy of holies, and take me in by the blood of the Lamb. My lips, here I am. Take me into the holy of holies, and take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. My lips, here I am. Take the call, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the call, cleanse my lips, here I am.
My childhood, I mean, it was good. Like any normal childhood, I mean, my mom would do her best to give us everything that we need. I had a perfectly normal childhood. But over the course of the years, it didn't always stay that way. You know, situations, an event occurred that disrupted that. My family wasn't as close as we were. The fighting and the house, everyone just moved out and everyone just went living on their own. We're not as close as we used to. It got to the point where we're like, we just don't even see each other for like months or like a whole year. Making money, that's how I cope with it. A workaholic, a hustler, whatever you call it, that's how I cope with it, making money. Yeah, I just became just money, 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 money. That's it. That's what I thought at the time was making me happy, but didn't know that at the same time it was like destroying me at the same time. I would drug traffic. I never worked for people. I would credit cards. And I mean, even though I was still making money, I was shoplifting. Like, I was making money to help my family. The moment I realized I'd gone too far was when I started messing with counterfeit money. I got in trouble for that. And I was on the run. And I came home one day to get some stuff. And my phone rang. And something told me not to answer my phone. but I answered it anyways because I thought it was an emergency call at the time, not knowing that's the phone call that was gonna get me caught up. But they were at my door, listening to me into my house. And I never knew they was outside. And all I heard was just the banging on the door. And I told my daughter to shush. And it was like, we know you're in there because we heard you on the phone. And I just opened the door. And the look on my daughter's face just said it all. And I tell him, I said, I'm not going. I said, I'll go with you, but you're not putting on any handcuffs on me, especially in front of my daughter. You're not gonna do it. And they said, all right, we'll wait until somebody come and get her, or we can just call ACS. I said, y'all can do whatever y'all wanna do, but I'm just letting you know I'm not leaving here in handcuffs in front of my daughter. I don't care what you do, but I'm not leaving here in handcuffs in front of her. And I was walking, and this lady stopped me, and she was like, oh, you know, would you like to try that church? And I was like, try your church? Took me 3 years, 3-4 years before I decided to really give the church a visit and see what it was all about. And ever since I've been coming to the church, I mean, I made a lot of progress. I don't get the urge to go outside anymore and do things. The people that I used to roll with, we never even had a falling out. They don't even call me, I don't call, and I don't even feel bad. I don't feel like I'm going through a withdrawal anymore, that I have to be on the road. I have to go outside and make money. I'm actually working a 9-to-5. I'm actually back in school getting my master's degree. I can actually smile and laugh. Honestly, when I thought I was making money, I thought I was happy. But now I realize I wasn't. Now I can honestly and truly say I'm happy.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, lay behind a stone, you live to die, rejected. Trampled on the ground. above all, like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and thought of me above.
I was in a very serious depression. My daughter passed away when she was 7 years old. She was sick with something called aplastic anemia. A couple of months after she was diagnosed, me and her father was at the store and some gangbangers came up and shot and killed him. And that's where my depression started. It disabled me. It was very crippling. I continued to live my life, but I was going through so much and nobody knew because I kept it inside. After a while, I had to go seek help. I would use the pills that I got to sleep because I couldn't sleep. I would wake up sick. I took 3 different kind of pills. I started abusing them. When I came to the Universal Church, they taught me like I was in a college. I'm embarrassed to say I think I sleep too much. No more pills, no more depression, no more insomnia. I'm doing great. I'm doing really good. I love life. If you're going through anything like I was going through, I advise you to find a number and call it and find a Universal Church in your area because they will help you.
Universal law, we do, I am, we do, I am, more than an overcomer.
my problems are gone.